A SpaceX executive says that the company's next-generation, fully reusable Starship rocket has already secured multiple commercial launch contracts. Set to debut no earlier than the first quarter of 2022, with a semi-orbital launch that aims to send Starship about 85% of the way around the Earth, Starship has a ways to go before it's ready to routinely launch payloads. Nonetheless, SpaceX is confident enough in Starship's eventual success to have effectively made it the foundation of every one of the company's future goals, both in the short and long term. Today, SpaceX's Falcon rockets have become a spectacularly successful revolution in cost-effective launch, through reusability and vertical integration, among other things. Thanks to that unprecedented affordability, SpaceX has been able to kick off the deployment of its Starlink internet constellation, launching more than 1,800 satellites and becoming the largest satellite operator in history, in less than 2.5 years. Where competition is possible, Falcon 9 dominates the global commercial launch market for both small and large satellites. And yet despite its staggering success, Falcon 9 remains at least one or two magnitudes too expensive and too performance-constrained to realize SpaceX's grander ambitions. Those overarching goals are simple enough and directly related. First, SpaceX, through Starlink, aims to blanket the Earth's surface with high-quality, affordable satellite internet that is either indistinguishable from or better than ground-based alternatives, ultimately connecting tens or even hundreds of millions of people to the internet. Second, SpaceX's founding goal has always been to make humanity a multiplanetary species, by enabling the creation of one or several permanent, self-sustaining cities on Mars. For the latter goal, Starship or a fully reusable rocket like it has always been essential, without which it would be prohibitively expensive to launch the sheer mass and volume of supplies needed to build a city on another world. Recently, if SpaceX's often hyperbolic CEO is to be believed, Starlink's success has also become dependent on Starship, with Musk stating in a company-wide memo that SpaceX as a whole could face bankruptcy if Starship isn't ready to launch 200-plus Starlink satellites per month by the end of 2022. While it's simply untrue that SpaceX is at risk of bankruptcy, there might be some truth behind Musk's statement. Fearmongering aside, the gist of Musk's argument is that Starlink is financially weak, under the current paradigm, where Falcon 9 delivers approximately 50,300 kilogram, approximately 650 pounds satellites to orbit with each launch. In the same vein as Starship, Musk believes that next-generation Starlink V2 satellites, several times larger than V1 satellites, will drastically improve the cost-effectiveness of the constellation, by allowing SpaceX to squeeze much more network capacity out of every unit of satellite mass. However, making Starlink V2 satellites several times larger would reduce the efficiency of launching them on Falcon 9, by an equal degree, hence the apparently dire need for Starship. Contrary to Musk's apocalyptic vision, even if it might be significantly slower and more expensive to deploy, it's quite likely that a full Starlink V1 constellation launched by Falcon 9 could still be economically viable. What it probably wouldn't be, though, is exceptionally profitable, which has long been SpaceX's main plan for funding its multiplanetary dreams. With a Starship capable of achieving its design goals, that could change. According to Musk and other SpaceX executives, the true cost, before payloads, of a flight-proven Falcon 9 launch is somewhere between $15 million and $28 million. At an estimated cost of $250,500 apiece, 50 to 60 Starlink V1 satellites raise the total cost of a Starlink launch to approximately $30.60, the range between marginal and total cost. In a partially reusable configuration, Falcon 9 is capable of launching about approximately 16 tons to low Earth orbit. Starship, however, is designed to launch at least 100 tons, approximately 220,000 pounds, and possibly up to 150 tons, approximately 330,000 pounds, to LEO for a marginal cost of as little as $2 million. Even if SpaceX is a magnitude off of that target and never gets beyond 100T to LEO, a $20 million Starship launch fully loaded with Starlink satellites would still cost five times less than Falcon 9 per unit of satellite mass launched. At 150 tons to LEO for $10 million, Starship would cost 15 times less. If SpaceX one day perfects full reusability and marginal costs do fall to $2 million, a 150-ton Starship launch could be up to 70 times cheaper than Falcon 9. For the exact same reasons, it could radically improve the cost efficiency of Starlink deployment, and finally make humanity's expansion beyond Earth affordable enough to be viable. Starship would also inherently revolutionize access to space for all other launch customers, not just SpaceX. According to SpaceX Vice President of Commercial Sales Tom Occhionero, Starship has already begun to make inroads with SpaceX's healthy list of existing Falcon customers. While relatively minor and inevitable, it's still an important symbolic step for SpaceX and Starship, as it attempts to deliver a launch vehicle so cheap and capable that it ushers the company's own Falcon rockets into retirement. SpaceX CEO Elon Musk says that the company is already thinking about the many potential ways its next-generation Starship launch vehicle could be used in space. Already, ideas publicly touted by the SpaceX CEO range from using cargo Starships to clean up space debris, with its mouth-like payload bay to a stripped-down, expendable variant of the rocket to rapidly send massive spacecraft throughout the solar system. Now, Musk says that SpaceX has also considered tethering Starships together in space, to create a form of artificial gravity for passengers on multi-month journeys between planets. As well as the possibility of turning entire Starships into all-in-one orbital observatories, a magnitude more powerful than Hubble. Apparently invoked during discussions with astrophysicist and Nobel laureate Saul Perlmutter, at least parts of the physics community are already considering the possibilities offered by using Starship as a sort of foundation or spacecraft bus that could carry and operate vast scientific payloads. While Starship has already been officially floated several times as a serious contender for launch services for major future missions, this concept would instead see Starship function as the spacecraft itself. As of 2021, Starship has yet to reach space or orbit once, but SpaceX isn't far from that milestone. Eventually, perhaps just a few years from now, Starship will have successfully launched to and operated in orbit dozens, or even hundreds of times and become a mature and reliable spacecraft. At that point, it wouldn't be out of the question to entrust Starships themselves to serve as long-lasting scientific spacecraft, exploiting a bus that could offer abundant power, propulsion, thermal management, navigation, and communications capabilities to any hosted payloads. That includes extensively modifying Starships on the ground to create vast space observatories, among numerous other possibilities. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.